if some people may look at the...
I don't care about Piccolo! Well, I mean, I do, as a fan. But her, she... All right, and today we got the most overrated characters of all time by Ola Masama. I said that right. You already know the vibes, no cursing. I'm not streaming right now, so maybe it'll be a little easier to not curse. One curse, three push-ups. I don't really got much else to say. Let's get straight into this. Okay, we lit. Long-ass intro.
Hate.
W-son.
We see it pretty much every day in our lives, no matter how much we try to avoid it. The feeling is typically directed towards someone or something, whether it be hate of a certain food or hate of a certain person. Depending on your perspective, such an intense negative feeling is justified to an extent. However, it is hard to justify going overboard with your distaste for specific people. In my opinion,
she was letting that hoe go.
There's a limit to the amount of hate one should receive, and usually this line doesn't get crossed. But when it comes to media, there are certain characters that receive hate that surpass.
I don't know. I'm not to hear his reasoning. Because, like, she deserves a lot of the hate that she gets, but a lot of it is undeserved. Okay.
That is what one may justify. Usually, most authors don't want one of their main protagonists.
I'll say this version of Sakura was the most annoying by far. Maybe the older one wasn't as, but this one? Hell no.
Slash good guys to unintentionally receive a disproportionate amount of hate compared to the rest of the cast. Certain circumstances, lack of context, or detached perspectives are some of the many reasons why the.
Chi-Chi is not annoying. Chi-Chi is not annoying. Chi-Chi is literally the only normal person in that entire show. I don't care what no one say, bro.
These characters get so much flack, even when their actions are reasonable. And you know, it's just not right. Someone needs to defend these fictional characters from the haters who try to slander their name to the ground every single day. So in today's video, I'm gonna have to represent some of these characters and do my best to clear their name. That's right, it's time for Ola Masama Ace Attorney. And we're gonna go through some of these cases and see if they have good reasoning to stand on. And for case number one, we have...
Heck! Didn't curse. No, bro. She is the only normal person in the show. I would be mad too if my husband got blonde hair and wanted to fight a 7 foot tall ant that literally was on TV mass murdering people and sucking them up in his tail. What do you mean you want my son to fight that? What? No, bro. No, bro. I would be mad too. Gohan literally had his neck broken before. What do we know?
Chi-Chi is a character from the Dragon Ball series who is the wife of the main character Goku, a mother of two sons named Gohan and Goku.
Fire music to choose, bro. Ace of... Oh my god. I'm gonna have to like for the editing alone, bro. Fire! It just sets the tone beautifully, bro.
And is also a martial artist and princess herself. Besides newer characters like Khalifa or Ribrian, Chi-Chi seems to be one of the few characters from OG Dragon Ball that gets a lot of flack. Many fans seem to have similar opinions by saying, "Bro, I'm telling you, Chi-Chi is so annoying. I really do not like her. Bro, I don't know who you are. Get out of my house." But one of my main issues with people calling her annoying is that their reasoning is simply not good enough. What people have deemed as annoying does not make sense whatsoever.
She don't want her son to be fighting aliens that destroy planets with their fingers.
However, and to prove this point, I wanted to look through some examples. For our first example, we can look at Chi-Chi not wanting Gohan to go to Namek to find the Dragon Balls to resurrect Piccolo. I feel as if some people may look at the...
I don't care about Piccolo! Well, I mean, I do, as a fan. But her, she got no reason.
This moment of Chi-Chi yelling and nagging Gohan as being annoying, but we should really look at the entire scope of the situation first. We as the viewer know that Gohan and Piccolo started to bond in the Saiyan Saga. But as far as Chi-Chi knows, Piccolo has kidnapped Gohan, almost killed Goku, and actually did kill Goku. Not to mention the fact that Gohan is like 4 or 5 years old and wants to go to a planet that's light years away with Krillin, Bulma, and Goku when he arrives. Mind you, she has no idea what's going on out there, and neither...
Mind you, he's literally recovering from getting his god dang neck. No, did he get his neck broken? Namek or was it Nappa? I don't remember, but...
There's Gohan. For all we know, there's some evil space emperor that's willing to murk anyone for fun. Why would any parent want to take a risk like that with their
son?
Of course she's going to freak out about an idea like that. Just let the adults handle the situation. Another example to look at is when Chi-Chi was mad at Gohan when he became a Super Saiyan. This instance might be more understandable to people, as some of y'all know that blonde hair is a standout feature in Japan and can be seen as a sign of delinquency in Japanese culture. So when Gohan pulls up with blonde hair, she's crying because she thinks he's starting to transform into some thug. For an analogy, imagine imagine your significant other comes home with your child and they both got a bunch of Lil Wayne face tattoos. You're gonna start tweaking, and I'd say you're justified in doing so. Also, Gohan becoming a Super Saiyan, a combat-enhancing transformation, leads into my next point. A lot of the people who dislike Chi-Chi seem to refer to the time she's shown to be a bit overbearing with wanting Gohan to study and go to a good school instead of fighting. Wait, hold up. Let me say that in a different way. Some people don't like that Chi-Chi, a mother, wants her son to study and...
You're not getting any pape from fighting these half-naked, bug-looking aliens. Yes, bro. Pick up the books. What are we talking about, bro? Fighting demons just to put fries in the bag because you have no money is crazy work. No.
And get into a good school rather than fighting planet-busting aliens. Now, And get into a good school rather than fighting...
Not getting paid for this is crazy.
Planet busting aliens. Now,
bro, look at this. Now,
if I'm not mistaken, a lot of parents probably have this thought process, or at least something close to it. I'm pretty sure most parents don't want their kids fighting all the time and or would want their kids to get a good education. It seems like a pretty obvious choice to me if I were a parent. She has witnessed multiple times how fighting has gotten her husband murked, and it was out of her control both times. The logical mindset would be to prevent that same path happening to your son despite whatever potential he has. This argument is also kind of helped by the fact that Gohan ended up enjoying being a bookworm anyways when he was older. Now, if you believe that Chi-Chi was putting too much pressure on Gohan when it comes to school, a new discussion can arise, and now there could be cause to hate on her character. Even the outbursts that people hate on Chi-Chi for are completely reasonable, or at least make sense as to why they happen. And for this portion, I really want to hammer home the point by showing this in real life, because let's be real, it's a lot easier to see and comprehend how an interaction works when you see it in person. So here's the reenacted context that led up to one of Chi-Chi's outbursts.
Dang,
toss me.
Goku coming back.
I'm back, everyone.
Hey, W Face Reveal.
Yo, hey Goku. I just started cooking dinner, so it's gonna be a little bit till it's ready, okay?
It was a crazy training session we had today. I gotta take off my clothes right now. They're so dirty, it's not even
funny. Wait, are you gonna do this in the living room?
Hey Chi-Chi, could you wash these for me? Ah man, I love this. You're the best thing anyone's ever asked for. Oh, Go on. Your clothes are dirty too.
I'm not lying.
You're gonna have to get them washed, right?
Should I just give them to mom?
Yeah, let's give them to your mom.
Bet.
Come on, Gohan, let's take a nice bath. You must be tripping. You think I'm gonna be cooking food for you? Yeah. Damn, these dirty clothes that you throwing.
You guys know how the rest goes. This was...
Mind you, not getting paid to train and fight too, bro. Where is the bread coming from?
Something that actually happened in the series, by the way. It's obviously not a one-to-one, but it's basically the same.
That's actually crazy. I don't remember that thing.
It may come off as annoying and short-tempered, but this interaction is something that I understand someone getting mad about. But you know, I do understand some of the reasons as to why some people hate on Chi-Chi. One thing that we should acknowledge is that Dragon Ball is a shonen anime. It's about fighting, getting stronger, adventures,
fair,
along with a plethora of other shonen elements. So
I can see as a fan you getting mad at Chi-Chi. I can understand that because she's literally stopping the plot. However, hating her for it? Hating her for being the only sensible character in the show? Come on.
You watch Dragon Ball, you want to see your favorite characters get the chance to fight and push their limits. You don't want someone to hinder that or prevent it from happening. It's also possible that Chi-Chi reminds some of y'all about your parents and guardians
about
certain things. To sum it up, Chi-Chi gets all this hate.
Just because I want the best for my little boy.
Oh yeah, exactly. Yes, she can have an annoying tone, but her actions are very realistic, and I bet that a lot of your parents would have somewhat similar ideals. As I grew up more and more, I really started to realize that Chi-Chi wasn't tweaking most of the time. And
I need this smile to fade in this gif. I'm gonna get tight if he lived his whole life happy.
If you're still a bit young, you may see something similar when you grow up. So I think...
Oh, I almost pressed the button. Someone got to teach that kid that this world ain't sunshine and rainbows, bro. I don't like how he smiled the whole time. I don't know. Something about it. Someone need to pipe his girlfriend or something. I don't know.
We can call this a close.
He need to get cheated on.
Close case. Let's move on to the next one.
Talk to me. I don't know who this is.
This kid from One Piece is a pirate from the Worst Generation and has been portrayed to have a rivalry with both the main character Luffy and another Worst Generation member, Law. Kid also boasts one of the highest bounties in the entire series at 3 billion berries, as he was a major contributor to the defeat of Big Mom and Emperor of the Sea. Kid seems to receive a lot of slander and flack by fans for things he simply cannot control. It's to the point that some people just don't even appreciate his character. As we all know, Kid has the same dream as other characters like Luffy and Blackbeard, and that is to become the Pirate King. The difference between Kid and them is that Luffy Luffy is the main character, so we know that man will be getting any type of mentoring and training he needs to get stronger. And Blackbeard is clearly set up to be one of the final antagonists of the series, so his strength will rise as it is needed to achieve that goal. But Kid is a side character, so we know dang well that he is not getting that same treatment, so he's gonna be going through his journey to become Pirate King blindly. All the intricacies and systems in the One Piece world are not made clear to him, so he's forced to learn them by himself. Imagine trying to learn calculus by yourself without learning any algebra beforehand. You finna be lost trying to wrap your head around a derivative. Another thing that should be addressed is Kid getting one shot by He Who Shan't Be Named. And I may be this guy's representative, but I won't lie, this did almost irreparable damage to Kid's reputation.
I'm not following. I'm trying though.
He was the one who picked the fight with Shanks. He got humbled. Let's move on. But I don't think it's that simple. Let's walk and look at everything that happened. Kid was about to use his strongest attack that Shanks saw would destroy a fleet of the ships. We also know that this is the same blast that Kid used against Big Mom to finish her off in their battle. So now that we've established how strong this attack is, when He Who Shan't Be Named hit Kid with the Divine Departure, the
Who's that? You gotta be naming the characters.
Attack Kid was charging up was also set off as well. This caused Kid's crew to get hit with two insanely strong attacks, which explains him going down in one hit. Another thing people criticize Kid's character for is the way he uses his devil fruit powers and haki ineffectively, which is valid to a certain point. People think that he can and should be stronger since his fruit revolves around magnetism. We've seen other characters like Magneto go crazy with magnetism, and all we've seen Kid do is make mechs. But as we all know, devil fruits are extremely hard to use to their utmost potential. There's no one instruction manual on them, so the user kind of just has to wing it and use it in their own way. So Kid using his fruit to make mini mechs are just what he's been able to discover with his abilities. And as for haki, Kid might not even know he has Conqueror's haki, so he really is just ignorant about a lot of things. If you've ever played an RPG or really any game without any prior knowledge, you'd likely have a similar experience to Kid. Aside personality and other character traits, a lot of the reasons people hate on Kid are usually things that are out of his control. It just becomes irrational.
I'm not. Do people not like him because he don't know how to use his power? And I don't know who's He Who Shan't Be Named. Like, I'm not following. I feel stupid.
At a certain point, if we're being honest, Kid is one of the few realistic depictions of what someone can do in the One Piece world with all the knowledge that we see Luffy.
Are these lyrics? I may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this shit for what? I'm shutting stuff down at tomorrow. What the? Wait, what is? Why are your chapters lyrics? I'm gonna start doing that. That's actually funny.
And his crew get. With that being said, what? We can close this case. Dang, another case.
I didn't follow that one at all.
So I'm good at this stuff. Anyways, if you're new and enjoying my premier attorney abilities, you might as well subscribe.
Hey,
and also sit back.
I already got it. I already locked in, boy. Come on now.
Next character we're gonna get into is fairly interesting to say the least.
Talk to me.
Sakura is a very popular or unpopular.
This fight was fine. This fight was tough.
Character from Naruto. She's a member of Team 7 and is the best medical ninja in the Leaf Village. Now, Sakura is a very special case as her actions in the anime can be pretty annoying. There's no justifiable reason as to why she's doing some of these.
Young Sakura is annoying as hell. I'll say that.
Things. Couple this with the fact that Sakura doesn't really have many moments in the anime of her doing relevant things, and you start to see why many fans dislike her character or just think she's useless.
But I don't think that's her fault. She's getting hit with the Rock Lee effect. She could be, she could be so much more fire, but because she doesn't have an eye, or she's not like the son, not like the daughter of some like crazy family, she just gets pushed in the back. Her and Rock Lee, bro, wasted potential.
However, I did say that this was a particularly special case and was very careful in my wording. Sakura in the anime is a victim of the animation studio, in this case Studio Pierrot or Pierrot, I don't know how to say it, taking certain liberties for the anime. This means that they alter some of the source material at times, a lot of the times including unnecessary changes. And seriously, there are a lot more than you think, and some of these moments are key to why some fans don't like this character. For example, a lot of the scenes we see of Sakura hitting Naruto are just filler scenes that the anime added. I promise y'all, this is one of the big reasons why people be hating on Sakura.
Then
there's the fact that Sakura is also just not that mean to Naruto in the manga. Like this scene, for example. Sakura is laughing because she sees that Naruto is stressed out from taking a written test. I think we can all agree that's pretty effed up. You laughing because
that didn't happen in the manga?
Your own squad mate is about to struggle on this test. But guess what? This never happened in the manga at all.
That's Sakura crazy.
Genuinely concerned for
Naruto. It must be Naruto's worst nightmare. He looked. That's some crazy hating, bro. I'm not gonna lie. Why would they do that?
Naruto, why did they change this? I don't know. We also need to acknowledge that the studio added unnecessary dialogue that makes Sakura seem more useless and dumber than she is. Like here in the anime, she's talking about whether she'd save either Naruto or Sasuke, when in the manga, she's determined to save both. One just...
That's...
Looks like someone who's conflicted between saving friends, while the other wants to save both no matter what, even if she isn't the strongest. They also just cut out some of the scenes where Sakura is helping Naruto or Sasuke in battle. We should all know how much of an effect that has on the viewer. If I never see someone contribute in battle, I'm going to assume that their value is not very high.
Oh, they're hoeing her. Oh, this is a crazy pose. I ain't gonna lie. She's getting hoed in this. That's insane.
High when it comes to combat. Another major part that the studio left out was the development between Sasuke and Sakura romantically. Now, for me personally, in the anime, it felt like the relationship was a bit rushed. It made sense, but the execution just felt a bit off. Come to my knowledge that in the manga, there were actually multiple scenes of these two sharing mutual feelings towards each other. Even something as little as the two blushing makes the relationship seem more mutual than one-sided.
Huh.
All you see in the anime is Sakura glazing Sasuke every other second and Sasuke basically pushing her away. Like, no, seriously, let me drop the lawyer act real quick. Personally, I'm not a manga fanatic and typically prefer watching the anime. However, definitely. I really hope y'all see that the anime can be drastically different from the author's original intention. I really do feel that a character like Sakura would be looked at way differently if the adaptation was better.
And she's tough, bro. Like, she has hands, bro.
Anyways, back to the bit. So as you can clearly see, a bulk of the hate that Sakura gets is from the animation studio doing a complete injustice to some of her better moments in the manga. If the anime didn't take as many liberties, I guarantee that Sakura would not be as hated as she is now. With that being said, I think I can say we have closed yet.
Even with all the stuff that they did to her, I'm not mad at Shippuden, Hinata. What the fuck? Oh, I cursed! Dang it, bro. I was so close, bro. The video's over. I'm not mad at Shippuden soccer. I don't hate it.
Another case. If y'all really want to hate on a character, go hate on that bum Kiba. He don't even do nothing. You know what? My bad.
Talking about I want to be the Hokage. Bro, your power is having a dog. Lock in.
Let's move on to the final case of the day.
Oh, yo. I fucking like spitting shit. Hey, bro. You are the only body the Cybermen have ever caught. That, and mind you, the Cybermen got him lacking, and then his team was like, Chaozu was like, okay, if that move worked, let me try it, and it didn't work. Yamcha is the only one who has died to someone latching around someone and blowing themselves up. That is crazy. That, and you got your girl took by one of the main supervillains of the show. The same dude that killed you took your girl.
The last case I wanted to briefly tackle is Yamcha. We all know about Yamcha and how he's the most memed character in all of Dragon Ball. Even the series makes references to Yamcha getting big. It's no secret. So what's the problem here? Yamcha doesn't truly get hate and vitriol thrown his way, so why is he even here? I decided to bring up Yamcha's case because I think the meme has gone so far that people don't even remember what happened in that fight. So let's run through his infamous battle with the Cybermen real quick because I think it should be enjoyable and eye-opening. So the fight starts and Yamcha seems to be the better fighter and well prepared for this. He gets thrown into the air, but he uses the sun as an advantage to start his offense. Yamcha then blitzes the Cyberman and hits it with the Kamehameha to seemingly defeat it. Then, after boasting about his victory, the Cyberman then sneaks Yamcha,
attaches
himself to him, and blows up. Thus, the meme is created. The problem isn't that Yamcha gets memed on or that people make fun of his death. That part
he didn't see it coming. He didn't know.
Doesn't matter. It's the fact that people see this image and think Yamcha just got murked with no difficulty whatsoever, which you can't tell me that some people don't believe. A lot of people probably forgot that he got snuck in the first place, and I've ran with this notion of Yamcha being some bum that got baked by Cybermen. That notion is only partially true. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, to be honest, I don't even know.
Still, bro, the only person that got caught lacking by that, bro.
This case is even closed. I'll leave that up to y'all. Now, I do plan on making a part two to this video that'll drop later. I do have about 4 or 5 other cases that I wanted to cover, so I'll work on those cases when I can. I hope y'all enjoyed the video, and I hope y'all like the slightly different approach I had in making this video.
Come on. The music was tough, bro. Extremely nostalgic.
Try the whole Ace Attorney bit for a while now, so I'm glad I got to do that. With that being said, have a great day and peace out.
Hey man, W video. Let me do these goddamn push-ups because it's freaking
so stupid. So dumb. I was so close to, bro.
1, 2, 3.
All right, y'all. That was my reaction to the most overhated characters of all time. Hope you guys liked it. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.